the three-dimensional hexagonal close packing. Already in two dimensions also we discussed about hexagonal close packing. So for hexagonal close packing in three dimension, let us take two-dimensional hexagonal close packed layers. See here, two-dimensional hexagonal layers are placed. The blue colored spheres indicate first layer of spheres. The blue colored spheres indicate first layer of spheres. The black colored spheres are spheres of second layer. Now, how the second layer is placed over the first layer of spheres? See here, the spheres of second layer are placed over the first layer such that its spheres of second layer occupy the depressions of the first layer. Depressions means deeps. So when we place second layer of spheres in the depressions of first layer, see here, all triangular voids are not occupied here. See, these are the triangular voids of first layer. Triangular void, it is triangular void, it is another triangular void. But here, see, it is also a triangular void. But this void is not occupied. See, this void, see, in this void, triangular void of first layer, that means layer A, is having downward apex. But a triangular void of this second layer B is having vertex upward. That means this void is not covered. Only this void covered. So here we have two types of voids. When a hexagonal square close packed layer, two-dimensional hexagonal close packed layer is placed over another layer, we get two types of voids. One is tetrahedral void, other one is octahedral void. Later I will discuss about these two voids. See, this is tetrahedral void, T, mentioned as T. This is octahedral void, mentioned as O. So, when a hexagonal close packed layer are stacked one over the other, we get two types of voids. One is tetrahedral void and the other one is octahedral void. Now, how to frame hexagonal close packing structure? So for that, let us take a two-dimensional hexagonal close packed layer and place another hexagonal layer over it such that its spheres of second layer occupy the depressions of first layer. So here two layers we have taken. Now place the third layer such that the spheres of third layer are exactly aligned with the first layer spheres. So this type of arrangement gives hexagonal close packing. So how to get hexagonal close packing? First layer, hexagonal close packed layer, first layer. And place the second layer over it such that its depressions occupy the depressions of first layer are occupied by the spheres of the second layer. Then it is B. If you place third layer, the spheres of this third layer are exactly aligned with the first layer. So this type of arrangement gives in hexagonal AB, AB, AB type arrangement there will be. If first layer A, the third layer also A. If second layer is B, fourth layer also B. In that way, AB, AB, AB type layer structure we will get in hexagonal close packing.